Welcome to Chair Yoga with Therese.
So with our spine nice and tall, shoulders relaxed, we can turn our palms up. If you're comfortable, close the eyes or gaze at the knees. And just take the next several moments to breathe. Feel the breath as it comes into the belly, into the ribs, into the top of the chest. Exhaling out of the chest, out of the ribs, out of the belly. As you continue to take deeper breaths, continue to let go of all thoughts, all to-dos. As you take that breath in and out, notice the changes inside. Notice how the muscles might expand and contract. How the body might create space. Maybe the sensations of the arms or the legs. Next breath, chin draws to the chest, stretching out through the back of the neck. Roll right ear towards right shoulder. Chin to chest, left ear, left shoulder. Chin to chest, stack up through the cervical spine. We'll take our head over to the right and then let that chin draw towards that right shoulder. Head lifts up, eyes on the horizon, come through center, over to the other side, chin comes towards left shoulder. Eyes on the horizon, head through center, release the arms and roll the shoulders up, back and down. Nice big rolls. Feel the shoulders lift up towards the ears. Feel them draw down towards the earth. Notice how it changes the more circles that we do. Maybe you start to loosen up a little bit more. Notice as you're circling, are you bending your elbows? Yeah, see if you can just keep the arms straight. And then reversing that direction. Releasing the shoulder, right ear, right ear, right shoulder, right ear, right shoulder. And then hold it here. Maybe take that right hand and just hold onto the head, giving a little bit extra. Release, head will come up. We'll bring left ear, left shoulder, and then maybe take that hand and just guide it through. And we'll release, inhale, arms up, and exhale, hands down. Inhale, hands up, big reach. Exhale, hands down, twice more. Inhale, hands up. And exhale, last one. Inhale, hands up. We'll interlace the fingers, press the palms to the sky, round the back as you bring the thumbs towards your knees, and then lift up, open up the heart to the sky. Exhale, round the back. Inhale, lift up, open up, heart to sky. And again, exhale, round the back. Inhale, lift up, release the arms. We're going to hold on to the frame of the chair and then straighten out those arms as we lean forward. So we want to get the stretch across the shoulders. If that's not enough for you, hands can come on top of the chair as you lean forward, but remember to keep the back legs of the chair on the floor. Hopefully you are not in a roller chair, a nice sturdy chair. From here, we'll stay forward. Let's take our right arm and we're going to float it up by our ear. And then we'll take our left arm, if it's okay, and bring it up towards that left ear. I'll look forward on the floor, maybe about 4 feet. Strong abdominals, shoulders down, heart is open. And engaging the abdominals, we're going to lift everything up. Bring hands to heart center. 3 breaths. Inhale, hands down and up. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale. And exhale. Once more. Inhale. Adding a twist, several progressions. Maybe stay here or twist to the right. Maybe stay here or lean forward and point that left elbow towards the outside of that right knee. See if you can let the thumbs come to heart center, lengthen tall through the spine, breathe deep. Next breath, we'll lift up, unwind through center. 1 breath, inhale. And exhale. Maybe stay here, or twist, or lean forward, and pointing that elbow towards the outside. Spine is long, feel that twisting in the torso. Remember, we're never, never, never looking for pain, but you want to feel a nice stretch. Spine is long, the breath is smooth. Next breath, we'll lift up, unwind through center, and release. Hands on the thighs, slide down, and slide down and see if you can get near those toes and maybe look underneath your chair. And then slide all the way back up to the top. And again, slide down, gaze underneath that chair, and then slide all the way up. Once more, we'll slide down, gaze underneath that chair, and then slide all the way back. Hands alongside the body, we'll circle through the wrist. Circle in the other direction. Pause the hands, inhale, hands up. And we'll alternate reaching up to the sky. Nice big reach. Feel that length in the arm, all the way through the waist, maybe even Then we'll reach both arms up to the sky, interlace the fingers, press the palms up, and then a little gentle arch to the back as you gaze at the fingers. Lift up, flip the palms facing your body, release the hands, bring it all the way down, roll the shoulders up, back and down. Single leg forward fold, right foot forward, flex the foot. We'll sit up tall, hands alongside the body, inhale, lift up, exhale, reach towards the toes. Inhale, lift up, and exhale down. Twice more. Inhale, exhale, reach. Inhale, lift up, exhale down. One more. Inhale, exhale, reach. Inhale, up. Bring the arms out to the side. And we'll twist to the left. Now, you're going to do your best to keep that knee pointing forward. It's going to want to go out to the side, but don't let it. We'll come through center. We're going to twist over to the other side. Spine is long. Breath is smooth. Unwind back to center. Release. Bring that right leg in. Left leg out. Foot flexed. Hands alongside the body, inhale, and exhale, reach forward, inhale up, exhale down, inhale, exhale, reach, inhale up, exhale down, last one, inhale, exhale, reach, inhale, lift, arms out to the side, palms down, and we'll twist as we keep that right knee pointing forward. Shoulders are relaxed, spine is long, smooth breath. Unwind through center, we'll take it over to the other side. Through center and bring it all the way down. Leg will come in, shoulders will roll up, back and down. Take the legs out long. Take the right ankle over the left, slide up. If you're able, get it above the knee. Bend that left leg, flex that foot, and come away from the back of the chair. From here, nice and tall. That foot will circle it around in one direction and then the other. Pause, keep that foot flexed. We'll go through three ranges of motion for our hips. We'll start forward, foot stays flexed, hinge at the hips with a straight back, and we'll just lean forward. Now, as you lean forward, sometimes you might feel some easiness in the sits bones. So imagine reaching the sits bones nice and long. Lift up. We'll turn towards that right knee. We're going to keep the back straight, and then we're going to reach the chest towards that right knee and across the room. Breathe into any tightness. Give the body permission to let go and relax. We'll lift up, come through center. We'll take it over to the other side. So upper body twists, and then we'll lean towards that foot. Now, remember, if going side to side doesn't feel good for you today, just take that stretch going forward. Remember, micro movements, there's no need to force. Lift up, come through center, lean against the back of the the chair. Now that right leg, we're going to take the hands behind the thigh and we'll flex that foot and we'll straighten and bend. And straighten and bend. And again, straighten and bend. We'll straighten that leg, press out through the heel. Several options. You can stay here or you can walk your hands towards the ankle, towards the foot. Now you're either going to hold on behind that thigh or behind the calf, but not behind the knee itself. Now, if you feel a little spunky today, I'm going to hold on to the chair with my left hand. My right hand, I'm holding on to my foot. You're going to hold on to whatever you have a hold on to. Then bring that leg in towards you, and then we're going to open it out to the side. You're pressing out through the heel. So there shouldn't be any grimaces right now. Nice and steady breath. Breathe deep. We'll lift up only if you are okay to cross midline. We will switch hands. And then we're going to guide that leg over to the other side. And you might not need to go that far at all. You want to feel that stretch. We're still doing our best to press out through that heel. Shoulders are relaxed, no heavy breathing. Then lift that leg back up. We'll bend the knee and place that foot down on the ground. And we'll just cross the, open and close the legs and just get a little loose in the hips. So same thing, other side. Legs are long, left ankle is over right. Slide that leg up and then bend the knee. Come away from the back of the chair. Left foot will circle around in one direction. And then circle around in the other. Pausing the foot, keeping it flexed, nice and tall. Three directions, we'll start going forward. Hinging at the hips with a straight spine, lean forward. So no wrinkles on the back of the neck. I know I always look forward because I'm keeping my eyes on the camera, but I want you to have no wrinkles in the back of the neck, so you're actually gazing in front. Breath is smooth. Maybe check in to notice how it might be different on the side. For me, the side is always a little bit tighter. Lifting up. If you want to try a different direction, we'll twist towards the left by the knee, and again with a straight back. Now, the reason why I'm encouraging you to do a straight back versus a rounded back is when you get into the straight back, you're going to feel it more in the hip. If I ask you to round your back, you're going to feel it more in the lower back, and we really want to target the hip. We'll lift up, come through center. We'll take it over to the other side. So we'll twist the upper body and then lean forward. Breath is smooth. Now, as we come back through center, lean against the back of the chair. We'll pick up that back thigh. And with the foot flexed, we'll extend and bend. And extend and bend. So remember, go where it feels right for you. Next time that leg is up, come out to your version of straight. Hands can stay behind the thigh or maybe down by the calf, maybe you're able to take hold of the foot, but I just want to make sure that you're not bending the knee to be able to hold on to the foot. Keep it to your version of straight and then go where that hand would be to help keep it straight. Right hand will come to the right side of the chair. If you'd like to go further, bring that leg in and then open out to the side. And smile inside. Soften through the furrow on the forehead, the cheekbones, soften the shoulders, maybe release the upper and the lower set of teeth if they're gritty. We'll lift up. If you are okay to cross midline, switch hands and we can bring it over to the other side and breathe. Steady breath, steady body. We'll lift that leg up and we'll take that foot to the floor. We'll come up and we'll just open and close the legs. Stretching out through the hip flexors. We'll do several variations. We're going to do our stretch first and then we'll do our crescent pose. We'll come over to the right side of our chair. Left foot is firmly on the floor with the knee on top. Lean in. We're going to drop that right knee down. Now your toes are untucked, so that means toenail polish is pointing to the floor. So the top of the foot is pointing to the floor. You can straighten out that right arm, and then, your left arm. You can straighten out that left arm. And your right leg, if you want, slide it back and hopefully you'll start to feel that stretch in the thigh and then maybe a little bit in the hip flexor. But don't worry, we're gonna go a little bit further in a second. You can choose to stay here or lift that right arm up and reach back. So imagine you're making a crescent pose, the back side of the body. And feel that stretch. We'll lift up, release the arm, lean in, and bring that foot in. Take it to the left side. Left buttocks is slightly hanging off, dropping that knee down towards the floor, and remember, toenail polish pointing towards the floor. From here, I can slide that leg back to get that stretch. If you'd like to go further, bring that arm up and then lean back. Soften through the throat. Also pay attention to the neck. If the neck doesn't like looking up at the ceiling, just look at where the ceiling meets the wall or look forward. Always adjust where it will feel right for you. We'll lift all the way up, release the arm, lean in, and bring that leg, come to the center of the chair, hands on the thighs. We'll take a nice inhale, exhale, round the back. Inhale, lift up, and exhale, round. Inhale, lift. Last one, inhale, lift, and exhale. We'll come in the front of the chair, lean back, and we're going to take hold of that right leg. So we're going to bring it in tight, and then take that left leg out and flex the foot. Now the right foot, we're going to point and flex. We'll circle around in one direction and then the other. And then pause. Take your right hand and hold on to the knee. Left hand is going to come out to the side. And we're just gonna circle that leg around. So we're gonna circle around and notice if it's a nice circle. So we're circling with the knee. Now let's circle in the other direction. We'll pause, bring that foot down. We'll draw the other knee into the chest and then extend that right leg out. And we're going to give it a nice big hug as we point and flex that foot. Circle in one direction. And then the other. Pausing. Hand will hold on to the knee, other hand onto the chair, and we'll circle that leg around. Nice big circle. Circle in the other direction. And then we'll bring that foot down. We'll extend both legs long, feet on the floor. Reach the arms up. Give yourself a nice big stretch, reaching the arms away from the legs. And release. Hands will come onto the chair for Savasana. You can scooch back in your chair. The feet can be on the floor. Or if you have a book or a block, you can put them underneath your feet. We'll turn palms up, relax the shoulders, and then close the eyes or gaze at the knees. And just feel the breath as it draws in and out through the body. So as you breathe in and out, just take stock of the entire body. Letting go of any remaining tension in the toes, the arches of the feet, the calves. Letting go in the hamstrings or the quadriceps or the hip flexors, the buttocks. Letting go of tension in the belly or the back, the chest, the rib cage. Releasing in the biceps, the triceps, the forearms, the hands, the fingers, the palms. Releasing in the shoulders, the neck, the jaw, the earlobes, the cheekbones, the eye sockets, the forehead. because it draws in and out of the body. Awakening inside through maybe wiggling the fingers and the toes. Scanning the body to see what might be different or the same. And just thanking the body for all that it's done and all that it will continue to do. Closing our practice with three rounds of Om, taking an inhalation to prepare. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Om peace to you. Om peace to your family and friends. Om peace to the world family. Bringing hands together, thumbs to heart, and bowing our head to honor the light and love within, and to honor that same light and love that connects each and every one of us. Namaste. So, thank you so much for sharing your practice with me today.